Hello, and welcome to Open Line. I'm Starlene Stringer. Irving has a lot of options for students interested in learning. As a new semester is set to get underway, we are focusing on higher education in this segment. Our guests are from Northlake College. Shonda Floyd is the Executive Dean of Liberal Arts, and Tim Samuels is the Executive Dean of Workforce Education. I want to thank you both for being here. And I want to start with you, Shonda. Let's start with when someone meets you who's never been to Northlake College, what do you tell them to give them an idea about the college?
Well, I tell them about a lot of opportunities that we have for students. There are really so many things that you can find to do at Northlake. In my area, I tend to lead people towards exploring academic options. There are lots of programs that they can go into on the academic side that will yield an Associate of Arts degree. There are also programs and courses that they can take that will allow them to see what they're interested in. So whether it's a program or a course in history, whether it's art, whether it's even a dance course, I try to encourage them to just explore what we have right here in Irving so that they can gain some experience with college and also understand what might be available to them in terms of workforce and career.
Wonderful. And Tim, I know Northlake is part of the Dallas County Community College District. So what does that mean to students?
That we're one of seven independently accredited colleges throughout the Dallas County area. In fact, one of the largest community college districts in the nation. And what I would hope it would mean to the students is that not only do you have the resources that you can take advantage of from Northlake College, but you really do have a wealth of resources throughout the entire college district.
I see. And back to you now, I want to ask you about the body, the student body itself. What does it mostly consist of? Is it students that are straight out of high school? Is it local students? Who's mainly there at Northlake?
Well, they're local students in terms of largely from the Irving area. However, 70% of our population is non-white or non-Caucasian. We like to tell students and just anyone that we meet, we are in the most diverse zip code in the entire nation. So our population is reflective of that. In terms of who goes to school, our average age is about 25. So that isn't that traditional student right out of high school. We tend to find people who have had some work experience and then they're coming back to gain a credential, to gain a degree, or perhaps even just to gain some skills that will make them more marketable in the current job that they work in.
I see. And so about how many students enroll each year?
In the fall, our enrollment is around 11,000, but if we do the annual enrollment, we hover about 17,800 students a year. So it's quite a population, and that's in multiple academic programs. Tim might be able to speak more to our enrollments on the
Wonderful.
CE side.
Wonderful, yeah, because I was going to ask you, Tim, what kind of trends you're seeing in growth?
Well, that's an excellent question, and to piggyback on what Dr. Floyd has commented on, so you're talking about 17,500, 17,800 on the credit side. But in non-credit instruction, we will see roughly unduplicated headcounts that will exceed 15,000 students a year. So you combine those, you're in excess of 32,000, 33,000 students that we're impacting and providing services to.
Wonderful. So, Shonda, tell me about some of the signature programs at Northlake.
Well, really excited right now because we're growing in lots of different areas, and one of the biggest areas is dual credit. Our enrollment has really jumped up, particularly in the urban population. We went from offering about 137 classes to courses to offering about 437, serving that many students, 137 students to serving about 475 students. So that's about a 43% increase in growth, and we're really proud about those Irving students in particular because they've touted 85% success rates.
Wow.
That means people who have enrolled in dual credit have been capable of achieving A, B, or C and completing those courses successfully. Overall, for all of Northlake, not just our Irving students, we have also had some growth. We've served about 975 students as opposed to last year this time when it was only roughly about 400. So we're really growing, really trying to increase that program because nationwide, you know, literature says and data says that students who enroll in dual credit, which means they're still in high school but capable of gaining a college experience, not just through taking a test, which is what AP offers them, but through experiencing a college course, a college professor, and learning some of those soft skills about how to navigate college life. How do I talk to my professor? How do I engage with the dean before they get there? And we're having success with those students. And that program really feeds very nicely. It used to be that we offered just a lot of courses and students would randomly take things, but now we're being more directed as a result of another signature program, and that's our Texas Pathways, or Guided Pathways to Student Success. And as a result of that program, we've really carved out different signature course certificates, course degrees that students can enroll in right from high school, staying aligned with their endorsements that they select in eighth grade, and able to complete an associate's degree at the same time they complete their high school diploma. So it's really a wonderful experience.
It sounds wonderful. And I see you nodding your head over there, Tim. What would you like to add to that?
Well, just on I had the outstanding privilege and tremendous opportunity to serve not only credit students through the pathway of an Associate of Applied Science, but also on non-credit. So I get the full blend of a potential college student. And where we're seeing growth, and we've experienced about a 5% increase in our credit awards on the career and technical education side, and most of that has been in the areas of accounting and business, our flagship program, which is Cisco Networking. Construction has been huge for the college and for the community, as well as electrical construction, electrical technology, and heard you, Starling, talking about video a while ago, so our video technology is doing extremely well. And we've been able to experience about a 26% increase over the past year in our non-credit instruction, with a great majority of that being credited to our ESL, English as a Second Language. And Dr. Floyd has already spoken to the diversity of the college, and we're seeing that on the non-credit side.
Wow, so there's a lot going on, and it all sounds great. For those listening right now and they're saying, hey, I want to enroll, I want to sign up, what's the step to do that? What steps do you take to enroll, and is there still time for this fall?
There's absolutely time to enroll. We will be enrolling individuals all the way through August 20th for our fall term. They should come to the college. They can go on our website and access an application, but we're truly here. There was even an effort that we had recently at our South campus. So my advice to them would be to go to our website, to come on campus. We'll be there to help you. We're waiting with open arms. We're truly here to serve the community.
Wonderful. And you've touched on some of the programs, or you mentioned dual credit for high school students. What are some of those programs you offer for high school students?
Well, in my area, it would be traditional academic paths. So we have pathways that lead to an associate in arts degree. So students would be able to take a lot of those freshman and sophomore courses, those core classes that they need, again, in order to obtain that credential of an associate's degree, but they would also be able to go on to a four-year institution and then complete their baccalaureate degree, having done those first 2 years at Northlake. Mm-hmm. Again, why it is so nice is because it gives them that experience of being in college, in a college course. The rigor is there, but I like to say the safety net of home is still there. So while you're trying to navigate a college course, you aren't in a completely new environment. You're still at home with mom and dad. You're still able to talk to teachers and get support that you might need. And in particular, I do want to note that our Irving students that enroll in dual credit are experiencing around an 87% success rate, while Northlake students overall in dual credit, just about a 70% pass rate. Hmm. Why am I highlighting that? It's because of the great infrastructure and support. We've really developed what we call an academy model with Irving that's working. And it's working largely because we have a lot of interfacing with the students, with the administrators, and we work together. So it's a truly collaborative effort that I believe you can see in the success rates, why we are being so successful, because we work together with Irving ISD, their students, their administrators, to make sure the programs are meeting everyone's needs.
Love it. Tim, tell me about the special training opportunities for business and industry.
Starling, thank you for that question. We have such a great opportunity to really work closely with business and industry and do what the nation is calling to do, and that's closing the skills gap of America. And from President Obama down to our chancellor and to the campus presidents, that's a focus for us as an institution to work closely with our community partners so that we can develop customized training opportunities to yield either greater productivity or bottom line in terms of its profit margins or whatever the case is, but it's really about increasing the skills of the workforce for our future workers. And we're developing programs all the time, from construction on to anything else, for whether it be project management, lean management. We do a lot of management training, a lot of information technology, and different forms of that with our business and industry partners. And over the past year, we have serviced over 450 employees just in Irving proper. And so we're able to make a great contribution to help to improve the skills of the incumbent workers, but yet help to bring about new workers for the company. So it's just a matter of working with those industries and those partners and doing our due diligence and a comprehensive needs analysis, and then help them foster a plan that's going to lead to more success for the companies.
Wonderful. And Shonda, I understand there's a special program for minority males?
Yes, we have the Minority Male Initiative, and it is focused on increasing success rates and retention for the minority male population. That's a population that has traditionally struggled in higher education. And through that program, we have a companion program, if you will, in terms of a student club and organization, and they provide interventional mentorship and support throughout the year that enables those students to have a place to voice both their concerns but also their issues that come up. We do try to individualize as much as possible. That's a hallmark of community college. So we like to deal with each student where they are, and that program allows us to address the needs of minority male students. I have to say something about dual credit again, though. Okay. In terms of that, it's successful for every student, even minority males. We've seen great success. So that's a program that could sort of capture everyone, but everyone should know that we do have other programs that will help individual populations like the Minority Male Initiative.
Thank you for adding that. And Tim, we mentioned the community college district itself. What are the benefits from attending a community college?
I think the benefits are vast and enormous. Number one, it's obviously very affordable, and in today's time, stretching of the dollar, it's an outstanding way to go in terms of declaring a pathway into a college. If you're going to pursue a university, you can literally still accomplish your first 2 years, which you could at a university, at a much reduced cost. So naturally, that's quite an incentive to seek out. And I think, too, because of the seven colleges that comprise the district, you have certain niche program opportunities from one college to the other. And we at Irving have, in Northlake, have ours with respect to Cisco and construction on the career and technical side. So I think as you look at where it is and what it is that you want to do in terms of career pathway, there's literally amongst the seven colleges an opportunity to discover that at any one of the locations.
That's great information too. And Shonda, I know a lot of people are interested in recreation and activities. So can you tell me about student life on campus?
We have a burgeoning student life. They're always doing something. So from lecture series to having individual student clubs put on programs, there is always something going on at Northlake. Our student services are housed in our H building, and they're very interactive not only with the community there on campus, but with the community at large. They do programs within Irving to keep Irving beautiful. We have a new bike program. So there are lots of things that the community can get involved in, but that our students are doing. We have the Common Book that reaches out across the academic and student services sides, but there are just multiple programs. There's always something going on, and our students are vibrant and they enjoy their college experience.
Sounds like they would at Northlake. And I have to ask you, Tim, what are you most proud of about Northlake College?
I love the student life. I love the cultural diversity. I just love the mix. It brings a college campus to life. And I do think, because I came here 17 months ago, as I was being interviewed for a position, I was also interviewed at Northlake because it was an opportunity to really understand the culture of the institution and its commitment to education and completion, and the leadership is sound, and it's certainly where I wanted to go to continue my employment career.
Shonda, I have to ask you the same question. What do you like most about Northlake College?
Oh, I love the culture and the people. I mean, everyone is truly sincere, and it's true to me and characteristic of a community college that we're a huge family. There's true care and concern, not only for the employees, but for the students. And I really feel like that comes through in each and every worker that is there and from the leadership down. So we really have a huge family that we just want to help one another. And most of all, we want to help our students obtain what they need to be successful in life.
Wonderful. Well, thank you both so much for being here. We really appreciate your time and the information you've shared.
Thank you.
You're welcome. For people interested in learning more, the website to visit is northlakecollege.edu. The phone number is 972-273-3000.